Don't ever think that if you run a coffee shop, you will become the most coolest person. It's gonna destroy you. That's why I never, saya tuh nggak pernah bilang barista saya tuh, kamu barista nggak. Saya selalu katakan mereka tukang air. To make them humble. Jangan pernah berpikir bahwa barista itu karena saya pakai apron, saya paling keren, saya nggak akan cuci piring. No. Bisa lihat di booth saya, ada perempuan yang baru kerja 2 bulan, dia bilang mau jadi barista saya bilang sama dia, okay, start from dishwasher. Harus. Karena saya, ya mungkin karena di Pilastro itu kami belum pernah hire barista yang jadi, Pak. Nggak pernah. Semua itu dari staff, mau jadi barista, belajar. Jadi. Nah, itu satu. Kemudian, pokoknya jangan merasa bahwa, oh, kalau saya buka coffee shop itu saya paling keren di sedunia. Percaya dah, Instagram ibu. Ya, at the end, it's not about cool or not. At the end, is your coffee shop success or not. Making money or not. If not making money, what for? Okay? Yeah, just be realistic. And then the other thing is, ya, hitung benar-benar kalau mau jadi coffee shop, your investment, apapun itu hitung dengan baik. Jangan tiba-tiba, pokoknya gue mau yang paling keren. Gue beli mesin yang segede-gede gajah. Yang akhirnya kemudian satu hari jualnya 10 cup. Nangis, Pak, jangan. Jangan, itu banyak orang terjebak di situ. Makanya saya bilang, understand first. Saya selalu katakan kepada sangat banyak orang adalah, to know how to make a coffee is different to understand a coffee.
Yeah.
To know how to make a coffee is easy. You can learn that between, I give you 2 days.
Yeah.
But to understand the coffee, itu kayak orang udah pacaran, Pak.
Yeah.
Wah, ini kopinya keluarnya bagus, oke. Okay. At least ini udah enak nih. Yeah. Itu udah mulai understand, Pak. Yeah. Tapi kalau udah pencet aja, pokoknya keluar ya, kopinya keluar.
Yeah.
Dan yang terakhir adalah, nah ini yang paling penting saya katakan. Jangan pergi ke suatu tempat, kemudian pulang jalan-jalan. Oh, I'm back from Melbourne. Let's bring Melbourne here. Let's bring Singapore here. Let's bring Korea here. Let's bring Japan here. Itu gawat. Kasihan. Coba bapak ini, yang kayak tadi nih, bapak ini nih. Coba suruh bapak ini, Pak, pesen kopi ya, Pak. Terus bareng apa, Pak? Jangan susah-susah. Kasih croissant aja kadang-kadang dia nggak mau. Pisang gorengnya ada kan? Is it wrong? No, Pak. Makanya saya bilang, tergantung kita mau buka di mana, kita mau konsep seperti apa. Konsepnya jelas dulu. But never bring anything from outside coming. Never. Saya ada bicara dengan investor dari Australia, dia ngajak saya. Invest. Saya bilang sama dia, kalau pakai brand kamu dengan barang kamu semua kemari, saya bilang enggak ada. Karena kenapa? Saya masih mau jual nasi goreng. Saya bilang. Karena pasti gawat. Terlalu banyak orang buka coffee shop itu pokoknya jangan melihat bahwa di sana keren itu kita kemudian mau bawa masuk. Jangan. That's the lesson. Yang penting hitung baik-baik. Jangan sampai salah. Konsep itu banyak. Gak harus kopi mahal, gak harus kopi murah. Tapi yang penting benar. Ini ada teman kita, Jul, dia buka di Cemara Asri. Saya lihat dia dalam 1 tahun ini very good. Very good. Different concept, but very good. Become a roaster. Very good. Ya, so far itu aja dulu dari saya paling penting.
Some last advice, I think be realistic. I think would be number one. Decide what you want to be. What is your shop supposed to be? Because it ultimately is a huge difference if you want to be Jake or if you want to be Common Grounds. I mean, like, this is a sad reality though. Nobody wants to be Jake. And Jayco is by far the most successful Indonesian coffee shop. Like, by far. It's not even comparable to anything else.
I think not only Jayco about the coffee shop. Yeah. I envy them. They never change the menu.
Yeah.
The most easiest coffee shop, they never change the menu. 1 year, all the same menu. Yeah. And they success. That's Jayco. I envy them.
Yeah. We all do. Number two, do the work. Nobody wants to. Everybody wants to spend all the time trying to figure out what's the name, what's the logo, what's our playlist going to be, what kind of chairs do we have. And then when you open, okay, then reality sets in. But if you're serious about what you're doing, you have an idea, spend the time. If you say you want to be Pilastro, for instance, what you should do is you spend a week from when he opens his shop until he closes the shop right next to the cashier and note on every single order that customers make. Sounds ridiculous, right? But that's the only way you will know if it's realistic or not.
Yes.
Because then you know his sales. It's gonna be awkward if you guys show up next week in the shop, but now he knows why. But I mean, like, if you do that, you know, okay, they're making this much money in revenue, approximately. Is that realistic?
Yeah.
Okay, my location is this much in rent. Is that realistic? Can I make money on this? If the answer is no, okay, maybe you can still do it if you work even harder and you have a great concept, but it's gonna be a lot of work. And be ready for that amount of work when you start. But number three, I think, be passionate about what you do and believe in it. Because once you make an agreement with yourself, you say, okay, I'm gonna do this, go for the 110%. Because a lot of people think, oh, coffee shops are booming, let's open a coffee shop. 3 months later, they're like, nah,
they're really
this
boring.
Is not working out, so I'm out. Yeah. And that's not necessarily a good use of your time or your money.